I'm the Monsanto chair in soybean breeding at Iowa State, and my team focuses on soybean breeding, particularly for cultivar development and germplasm lines development. It's a soil-borne fungal pathogen, Macrophemina faezulina, that causes charcoal rot of soybean. It is a devastating disease. It seems to be more prevalent in the southern regions of the U.S., but strains even up in Minnesota have been found. So charcoal rot has been found, in Iowa it has been found. It caused a lot of damage a few years ago. To think about it, control of these kinds of diseases, when, you know, especially it's a soil-borne root and stem disease, there are very few immediate mitigation opportunities that are available. So genetic resistance is probably the best way to go about it. As a breeding program, we have an interest in developing cultivars that have better tolerance or resistance to different pathogens, including charcoal rot of soybean. And there are other pathogens we work on as well. So one of the approach we have taken through support from the United Soybean Board in the past is that, can we build in resistance against charcoal rot and soybean in the more northern maturities? We have created new hybridizations so that we can try and combine charcoal rot resistance in more elite germplasm. The path we took to get to that stage is we screened hundreds of accessions through support from the United Soybean Board, and we found out which are the best accessions in the soybean germplasm bank that have resistance against charcoal rot in the group maturities 1, 2, and 3, which is an area, an adaptation area of soybean that we still do not have availability of good charcoal rot resistance. And as a breeder and other people that work in this field, we have to think about that most of these pathogens were not really a problem until they became a problem. And with the change in the production system, the change in some of the weather variables, we have to be aware of and constantly, consciously work towards improving the genetic resistance, which is one of the best ways of overcoming resistance. It feeds in into improved profitability for farmers because they don't have to take mitigation steps. They have a genetic package that has resistance. On the research side, we have done a lot of different things related to this project that feed in into that breeding aspect. We were able to identify unique sources of resistance that were previously not known. We were also able to leverage some of the genetic analysis that can be done with the kinds of large-scale screening that we did. And through the analysis, we were able to pinpoint the genomic regions and candidate genes that condition that resistance. So that's very unique, because now we have understanding of the genetic factors that help in giving tolerance towards charcoal rot. One of the other approaches we have taken and are currently working on is we are trying to now come up with prediction models where we can determine that what is the level of resistance in all of the accessions in the germplasm bank, soybean germplasm bank. And then when we have the progenies, we can actually do those, apply those predictions without having to test in large scale field nurseries, which I don't need to tell you, they're very intensive, that requires a lot of sampling of the plants, cutting of the plants, rating them. So we are leveraging both phenotyping tools as well as genomic tools to make those improvements. One of the other aspects of working with such a complex disease is the necessity to have good, meaningful, productive collaborations. And those collaborations, they cut across disciplines and across boundaries of institutions. And that's something that was achieved through the funding that we had from United Soybean Board that focused on charcoal rot. So it's a very collegial, collaborative effort. And that's something that, in my experience, I've learned that is very powerful and very impactful, that leads to that return of investment that farmers are making for the problems that they identify to be important.